The problem of plastic waste is huge. About 245 million tons of plastic are produced annually around the world. And believe it or not, that represents about 70 pounds for each person. So where does this plastic end up? Studies show that 93% of plastic waste that we produce is not recycled and actually becomes trash. And unfortunately, a large percent of plastic waste actually ends up in our waterways, particularly in our oceans. Scientists first reported plastic pieces in the ocean back in the 1970s. And today, plastic particles have been found in every part of the ocean, from the Arctic to Antarctica to the deepest seafloor. Vast oval-shaped garbage patches in the ocean called gyres are formed by currents and winds. And once they are trapped in these dead zones, plastic particles may persist literally for centuries. There are five massive gyres of trash particles swirling around in the Indian, Atlantic, and Pacific Oceans. The amount of plastic debris in the Pacific Ocean gyre has grown 100-fold in the last 40 years. Unlike other types of trash, plastic does not biodegrade. Instead, it photodegrades with sunlight, breaking down into smaller and smaller pieces. Those bits are consumed by marine creatures, from birds to fish to even insects. And as a result, the chemicals that are used in plastics, like phthalates, maybe flame retardants, they have been found in almost every type of sea life. Plastic is invading more than our oceans. It's actually getting into our food chain. Our problem has truly come back to us full circle. By one estimate, the weight of plastic finding its way into the sea each year is estimated to be the equivalent to the weight of 40 aircraft carriers. The gyres that these scientists study account for about 25% of our planet's surface. At this point, the problem is so large that experts believe it's impossible to try to clean up all the plastic that is in the gyres, although researchers and environmentalists keep looking for solutions. And there are initiatives like the Seabin Project that seek to remove plastic and debris from oceans around the world. And packaging sources like Oceanbound clean up plastic from waterways before reaching the ocean to reuse in packages like many of our very own. But even with these innovative efforts, at this point, identifying and reducing the pollution at its source upstream is the best way to reduce plastic in our oceans. The founder of Washed Ashore, Angela Hazeltine-Pozzi, says that people throw things away without actually knowing where away really is. The average American will throw away approximately 185 pounds of plastic per year. Single-use plastic is by far the most significant contributor to this problem. 8 of the 10 top items that are found on beaches during international coastal cleanup days were plastics relating to eating and drinking. So think about plastic straws, plastic bottles, plastic bags, plastic cutlery, all that we use one time, but they remain on the planet for a very long time. And here's one more fact. Approximately 380 billion plastic bags are used in the U.S. alone every year. That's more than 1,200 bags per U.S. resident per year. And plastic bags can take 400 to 1,000 years to decompose. And even then, when they decompose, their chemical residues remain. So yes, we have a problem. But in addition to the work by researchers and scientists, there are many things that we can do as individuals to help reduce that plastic waste. We've all heard the three R's: reduce, reuse, and recycle. Let's eliminate plastic in every way that we can. We can search out products that are made from recycled materials. We can look for packaging that is more earth-friendly. Reusable bags for groceries and produce can radically reduce those pesky plastic sacks that accumulate in your kitchen. And personal reusable straws belong in everybody's bag. Remember Nora the leaping salmon from The Artists at Washed Ashore? Every plastic piece was collected by volunteers globally along the shoreline. And now they are repurposed to build awareness about the dangers of plastic waste. We can all be part of the solution when we take action and when we help others do the same.